Matthew Seligman is special counsel for election integrity at the Campaign Legal Center, and he's also taught a course on disputed presidential elections at Harvard Law School. Matthew, thank you so much for being with us, and a happy new year to you. When you listened to this conversation, you said that you saw two crimes possibly being committed under Georgia code. The first one you said was intentional interference with performance of election duties. Explain that to us.
Thanks for having me on, Brianna. It's great to be here. So the first theory of criminal liability that I see in this conversation is that Georgia law makes it a crime to intentionally interfere with or hinder or delay an election official's performance of his duties. And state election law requires Secretary Raffensperger to tabulate, compute, and canvass the presidential votes as certified by the counties in November. And he's already done that. The president on this phone call seems to be pressuring the secretary to change that canvass. And that sounds to me like it might be intentionally interfering with Secretary Raffensperger's canvass.
That's very interesting. And then the other possible crime that you say the president committed is, quote, criminal solicitation to commit election fraud. Explain that.
That's right. Georgia law also makes it a crime to solicit or request that someone violate the election laws. And so it also sounds like the president is asking Secretary Raffensperger to commit a crime. Now, it's a little less clear that that the president committed this crime, I think, because the scope of the legal duties that this second provision applies to is a bit narrower. So I think that's less clear. But the first legal violation, I think, is much stronger.
And in the case of a state criminal prosecution, you know, if that's something that somehow came to fruition here in the next few weeks, that would be something the president could not pardon himself from. What if there's a prosecution after he leaves office?
That's correct. The president's power under the United States Constitution to pardon is to pardon offenses against the United States, that is, federal crimes. These are state crimes, and the president has absolutely no power to pardon himself or anyone else for violations of state law.
Do you think that there will be any sort of prosecution or investigation in Georgia?
It's hard to say for two reasons. First, there are so many political and policy questions that go into whether a prosecutor chooses to bring a criminal prosecution. The second, and I think the most complicated aspect of this potential criminal case, is that it depends so much on what the president actually believes. In this phone call, he repeated numerous debunked conspiracy theories that there's definitive proof are false. But nonetheless, we don't know whether he actually believes them or not. If he knows they're false, then the criminal case is a lot stronger. But if he's really bought into them and he really believes all of these conspiracy theories, then it's a lot harder to say that he intentionally was trying to get Secretary Raffensperger to violate his legal duties. So ultimately, it's going to depend on how prosecutors interpret the president's incoherent and sometimes inconsistent statements on that phone call.
Matthew, thank you so much for clearing some of this up. We appreciate it. Matthew Seligman.
Thanks very much.